I wanted to do something new. And so Alex, our CEO, gave me the opportunity to build something from scratch, build a new system that is not just focusing on storage, but application integration and data management. And that's basically why I joined DDN as a CTO in 2018. And today, I want to focus primarily on two products, which are named EXAScaler and Infinia. Let's go downstairs in my office. You know, we have a great whiteboard. If we need to sketch something up, we can do this too. So if you guys hear lots of jets flying around today, this is Fleet Week in San Francisco. Obviously, that wasn't planned this way, but this is why we have lots of jets, you know, potentially in the background. So EXAScaler is our bread and butter product. So it's the one that is basically powering the largest, you know, AI training systems in the world. It's also used primarily as a production system inside NVIDIA. So everything NVIDIA does internally for their production workloads run on EXAScaler. NVIDIA has also started testing Infinia, which is another product I'm going to talk about in a few seconds. But EXAScaler is really designed for massively large-scale systems. If you look at every superpod out there that is used in production, it pretty much all of them run on EXAScaler. And we use it primarily for everything where there is massive throughput requirements, massive scaling, capacity, and performance. So the Infinia product is a very different product. So Infinia has been developed from the ground. This was the project that I started essentially when I joined DDN about 7 years ago. The intent of this product is very different. It is primarily an object store product, but it covers much more than just object store. Object is just one of multiple data interfaces the product provides. The system has interfaces that provide database access through an SQL interface. We have capabilities to use it as a notification bus. This is something that is very critical in AI workloads, where you need to cover end-to-end a workflow from the creation of data, the way it gets handled throughout its lifecycle, until it's used potentially in a query that a customer asks, you know, ChatGPT or any type of other application that is actually part of a bigger AI workflow. Infinia also covers a lot of other very complicated problems. It makes it more attractive also for service providers. It is a pure software product. It has really built in architecturally lots of capabilities around multi-tenancy, provide technology as a service, and it has some pretty deep integration capabilities through an SDK that allows customers to accelerate any kind of applications and any kind of AI workflows outside of the core product itself. And so we have a lot of partner, you know, build-up development going on with ecosystem partners to enable the acceleration through our technology by using our Infinia SDK product. So Infinia was never designed or built as a replacement for EXAScaler. It is really a product that will solve problems that EXAScaler simply doesn't. And so the Infinia technology was meant to be from day one a technology that allow you to build very large-scale systems that are more consumed as a service on one hand. On the other hand, to address very strong requirements around multi-tenancy. So EXAScaler is really great if you need larger coarse pockets of multi-tenancy. But if you want to do like very fine-grained multi-tenancy where people have essentially tenants for every individual service, for every individual application, and you want to have different security authentication models around that, and maybe even availability and reliability requirements around it. That is what Infinia has been designed for from the ground up. And so the Infinia technology was meant to be, provide storage technologies as a service, but at the same time provide more than just storage. So Infinia can store structured and unstructured data, but it can also store data significantly enriched by metadata. Particularly in AI, this is becoming, you know, very, very critical, where it's not just all about the data. It is the data that over time constantly gets enriched with metadata. And people make decisions on what data to process and look at based on metadata. I always call Infinia software-defined and hardware-aware. And I think that last part is very critical. So the software-defined piece is very important because in a lot of environments, you cannot bring your own hardware. A cloud provider, for example, it's very hard for them to bring in a new piece of equipment because the process of integrating this into all the automation, everything just takes a very long period of time. So what is very appealing for them is really to have a pure software-defined offering where you just bring a software and they integrate the software through APIs into their services. And so Infinia is not just software defined, as I said, but hardware aware. So what does that really mean is, it tries to give you the capabilities of a system being more like a box from an operations perspective. So the question about, you know, how do we differentiate compared to other vendors? And so one of the ways I would like to describe this is, there are things you can do above the stack and then there are things you can do below the stack. So what I really mean with that is, if you look at what DDN has done over the last, you know, two decades, is primarily below the stack. So what that means is, DDN was constantly driving efficiency of storing data in any possible way you can think of. It is about, you know, increasing density. We have the highest density of flash that you can fit into a rack today, for example. It is about compressing data. So, you know, if the data is stored in the system and you compress it, you further increase density. And at the same time, you reduce cost. We constantly drive reduction of cost on any level. It doesn't matter if this is driving down the cost of the media we're using, driving down the cost by reducing the actual physical storage we need in a system through means like compression, or simply reducing the number of ports you need because networking infrastructure is incredibly expensive, particularly at very, very large scale. So we try to increase density per port, density per rack unit. These are all things that we consider below the stack improvements. So it's really the, you know, hard work of constantly driving down cost and infrastructure to provide customers energy savings, cooling savings, which turns into energy savings, and then at the same time, floor space. Because floor space, particularly if you look at enterprise, is very, very critical. We will have a system in the first half of next year that is able to put over 100 petabyte of uncompressed data onto a single floor tile in your data center. So very, very significant differentiators compared to our competitors, which usually need, you know, 10 times as many ports to get the same throughput, or multiple times the number of racks and kilowatts in terms of energy to deliver the same capabilities that we deliver with our products today. So when we talk about the above the stack optimizations, it is how we actually accelerate the customer's application, not purely by infrastructure capabilities and enhancements, where we take a faster interconnect, a faster way of storing data on the media. It is the integration into the application stack directly. To give you an example, on Infinia, for example, customers have choices of interacting with the Infinia system. So they can use S3 as an interface for putting and getting data in and out of the system. It is super simple, it's very low latency, but there are inherent limitations on how low you can get the latency with that through the S3 protocol itself, because the S3 protocol is basically providing a basic framework on how to interact with the system. In order to overcome this, Infinia has a software development kit, which essentially provides you libraries and header files that you can directly integrate into your application. And then we allow you to do a lot of the data management and capabilities inside your application. So if you do an operation like you put an object into the system, if you use S3 for that, you essentially connect to a remote S3 server, you're negotiating a secure communication line with him, you send the data to him, that S3 service on the other side needs to now compress, erasure code the data, send the data east-west to other nodes in order to store the data in a protected way. If you use the Infinia SDK, all of these capabilities happen in the customer's application itself. It also enables you to use offloading capabilities where we can do, for example, RDMA over either Roki or over InfiniBand to transfer data directly by hardware acceleration into memory and the media on the remote systems. So this is, the above stack is really more about software integration and application integration and acceleration. Below the stack is really more about infrastructure cost efficiency optimizations inside the products that we provide. So we obviously care about long-term strategy and long-term roadmaps, but we don't have a problem adjusting where our customers are taking us. So we are very driven by input from our customers. And so whatever we see their challenges are, this is what we are interested in solving. And so we're very, you know, happy to take on these challenges and drive the roadmaps in order to solve the biggest problems for our customers.